Captions and subtitles are an incredibly important part of a viewer's experience when consuming your content on YouTube or social media. With an SRT captions file of your video, you can upload the sidecar file directly to the platforms that support closed captions. However, some video sites don't display closed captions, so you'll need to create a video with burned-in open captions so they're always visible for the viewer. In this video, we'll discuss how to use an SRT file to create burn-in open captions for your iMovie project. Let's create a caption style template before we start copying and pasting text into iMovie. There are many styles you might consider for your video's open captions. You might want to go with a standard lower third style with white or yellow text. Perhaps you want to mimic the style of the viral videos that have horizontal black bars on the top and the bottom of the screen, placing captions at either the bottom or the top or a combination of the two. You might even want to individually customize the text throughout the video to make certain words or phrases stand out. Whatever it may be, it's best to decide on the style now rather than later. For this video, we're going to do a standard lower third style. To get started, open your iMovie project, click on Titles, and then drag and drop a standard lower third title onto your project timeline. You'll need to reformat the title for captions by center aligning the text and matching the font, size, boldness, and outline of the two lines. Make sure both lines are the same. For our example, we're using Avenir Heavy Font, 70-point font size, bold, and outlined. With a lower thirds caption template ready, you can start adding information from your SRT captions file. Whenever there's a new line of dialogue in your project, you can duplicate your original title block and place it within the timeline so that the text matches what is being said. We recommend that you copy and paste text from the SRT file into your title since it will save you from having to type everything out. After completing this, there are two more steps in the process of creating burn-in captions for your video. In the next segment, we'll discuss the best way to edit these captions and subtitles for your iMovie projects.